Hi, and welcome back to HP How To For You. I'm Steph, and this is Bill, and we're here to bring you tips, tricks, and how-to information every 2 weeks to help you get the most out of your HP products.
And today we're going to talk about the new Edge browser from Microsoft. It's pretty cool. There's a lot of things you can do with it.
Oh, I know all about Edge. Remember, I updated to Windows 10 while I was in San Francisco. Then I updated my drivers with HP Support Assistant while I was on the beach in Hawaii. Maybe while you're talking about Edge, I can go somewhere else.
How about, since you know so much about Edge, you stay here and I take the trip?
That's not how this works. You give the tips and I make sure it works, which obviously I can do anywhere. But I'll do you a solid and stay here this time.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Now, Bill, will you tell us about Microsoft Edge, the new browser that came out with Windows 10? From my experience, it is awesome. There's this thing that you can do where you can make notes and annotations on web pages called web notes.
Yeah, web notes is great. It's a great asset for taking notes on a web page and sharing those with friends. Let's show you what web notes can do. The Make a Web Note button is located on the right of the Edge toolbar. When you click it, you're given two tools to mark your page with, a pen and a highlighter. When you click either of those, you're given the option to choose your ink color and nib size. You can also pan around the page, erase anything you might have accidentally highlighted, crop out parts of the page, or type a note. Before you leave the web page, you'll want to save your notes and marks if you plan on looking at them later. You can save it to OneNote, Favorites, Reading List, or create a new folder for it. Or you can share your notes with friends through email or social media.
This is really cool. So how do you open a previously saved note?
Well, that's really easy too. Go to the folder that you saved it in. In this case, Bill's Notes. And click on your web note. It saves them as an HTML file so that you can access it anytime.
Cool. I just saved a page with some web notes.
Oh, let's see it.
Ta-da!
You know, this tool can be useful too.
Oh, it's very useful. I've used it for work and school and mocking up various web pages, but I really like mocking up pictures of your face. You look good in a blue mustache.
Apparently so. Thanks.
Yeah. Tell us more. What else can you do with Edge?
A really helpful tool is the Reading List. Reading List lets you save web pages to read later. Like those cat memes that you love so much. You can save them and you can watch them again and again and again.
You know me too well.
You can just click the Add to Favorites or Reading List button and they're always available to you.
I can't live without my cat memes.
You can click on the hub icon, which is next to the Add to Favorites or Reading List button, and then select your reading list.
Sweet, I already set up my reading list and I add to it daily.
Oh, cool. What's in your reading list?
Oh, you know, those cat memes I like. I do articles about filmmaking and editing, anything for work, and articles about famous celebrities.
Very cool. Like to see those sometime.
Can you please tell us about another feature?
Gladly. So, all those articles that you saved, you probably want to read them without all the distractions that you see sometimes on other web pages, like ads, pop-ups, links to other articles. You can use the reading view. And when you activate the reading view, it eliminates all those distractions, so it reads more like a book.
Ooh, I like reading books. How do I activate it?
Well, all you need to do is click on the reading view icon, which can be found on the right side of your address bar. You can also use the shortcut Control-Shift-R to activate the reading view in Microsoft Edge. Then it's just like reading a book.
I wouldn't say it's just like reading a book. I mean, it's really hard to curl up on the couch with a laptop, and they also don't have that old book smell. But they do have some articles that you can't get in books.
Oh, really? What kind of articles?
How to embarrass your vlog host without really trying.
Can you share that with me?
Nope.
OK. Okay. Well, if you ever wanted to share it with me, I'll show you how to do that.
Okay. If I ever want to. Probably not.
Well, if you ever do want to share it, it's as simple as clicking on the share icon in the top right corner of your browser. A share panel will open and present you with the different apps you can use to share your articles. All you have to do is make sure that you have that app installed, like any social media app, and it's that easy. You can share it.
Cool. I know what I'm going to share.
And that's a wrap.
I'm going to share it with all my friends at HP. It'll be a hoot.
Sure, it will be.
Don't forget to follow our vlog on YouTube at youtube.com/howtoforyou or on our HP support forum at
hp.com/supportforum.
You can find us there under the blog section. Check us out and leave a comment on what you want to hear about. Thanks. Yeah. You're welcome. So,
no, I don't like that one.
And a great asset for being product. Being product, because you can be product.
Hey, I'm ready.
I'm not.